Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. can see clearly now the rain is gone.
I can see clearly
all the things will go away.
Here is the rainbow I've
been praying for. Praise the Lord.
Rastaman vibration, yeah,
positive.
I and I vibration, yeah,
positive.
I am man vibration, yeah,
Irish.
Positive vibration.
can see clearly now the rain is gone.
I can see clearly
all the things will go away. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
clearly now the rain is gone.
I can see clearly
all the things will go away.
Here is the rainbow I've
been praying for. Praise the Lord. The Magic Polar Bears Visit Africa. This book is one of the books that belong to the Polar Bear book series, the two polar bears who travel the world, and also the Magic Polar Bears. There are 14 books in this selection that comprise the entire collection. And here we are in Africa. These are the lovable, wonderful polar bears named Glacia and Snowglow, who were born on the Denali landscape mountains in Alaska. The Magic Polar Bears Visit Africa by Laurel Marie Sobol. The iceberg hurled past the Ivory Coast at the tip of South Africa as it swung toward Africa's central western coast. The bears woke up well before the iceberg moved them into these seas off of West South Africa. As the bears appeared from their den, the sunlight nearly blinded them. They crouched down low and backed into their den to reemerge very slowly as their eyes began to adjust to the sun's glare. As vision cleared up for them, they saw a grand sight to their immediate east, the continent of Africa. Glacia's nose quivered with excitement as the odors off the continent drifted past her nose. Snowglow's eyes shone and his ears perked up. He was absorbing the scents from land, too. They smelled things they had never experienced before. Wafts of high mountain lakes and high rising waterfalls drifted their way. Sand dunes and deserts and high mountain air that kissed the sun came their way. The smell of animals of all kinds assailed their senses and boggled their minds. They smelled lions, elephants, gorillas, monkeys, birds, zebras, and many more. They were so excited about all the aromas coming their way that they could barely stand still as they waited for their iceberg to slow in a chilly spot just south of the equator. Thank you. They stretched and yawned and stretched some more as they readied themselves for the long swim from their iceberg to the African coast. Luckily for Glacia and Snowglobe, the climate in Africa at the time of their arrival was about late winter and still cool enough for them to get about the continent pretty much as well as they pleased. The temperatures would be uncomfortable at times, and they would seek shelter in wooded groves and forests to find the coolness they required to survive any bouts of heat spells. Glacia and Snowglobe had landed on shore south of the equator, just north of the Congo River in Africa. They were elated to stretch out their legs and necks as they strode along the Congo River, heading upstream. Their journey in Africa would take them to the very heart of Africa and to some of the most fantastic places on the planet Earth. Glacia told Snowglobe, "We will have the time of our lives here in Africa, and we will see some things that we will surely never, ever forget. Just me and you, my dear Snowglobe." Snowglobe shook his assent as he happily strode forth with his sweetheart, Glacia. Snowglobe was the first one to see a wild elephant and said, "Oh my, Glacia, look at that huge animal. Go stealthily by him so he does not chase us." The two bears silently moved past the giant elephant. Thank you. The polar bears enjoyed their walk through the Congo as they went upriver on a long trek moving towards Lake Victoria in eastern Africa. Along the Great Congo River, they learned some amazing facts. They discovered that it was the deepest river in the whole world, because it was. Feet deep in some areas. They knew of the elephant electric fish that may change the way medicine and neurology would be viewed. The Congo River was also the only one in the world with 60 miles of rapids. Since rapids are a type of falls, some people believe the Congo to have the longest falls too. The pair took their time along the way and enjoyed the sights and sounds of Africa everywhere they went. They saw many more elephants, peacocks, West African crown birds, and the boa boa tree in the evening sunset. As Snowglow and Glacia made their way further into the African interior, they made sure of avoiding people as much as possible. They also realized that it was no wonder that most hurricanes seem to originate off the western shores of this beautiful continent, for the weather here in Africa was all kinds, The rainy season was now upon the plains and most of the places they ventured. Sunshine was mild when the sun did smile on the earth. The weather was almost otherworldly, with clouds rising high into the heavens and rainbows dancing across the forests and dipping into the rivers. Snow globe and glacier made good time through Africa without even trying to do so. Nothing in Africa seemed to daunt the polar bears, not even the heavy clouds of mosquitoes that often swarmed them along their journey. Over a period of about 3 months had gone by when Glacier and Snowglow came upon the majestic Victoria Falls and watched the monkeys swinging from the trees above the falls, laughing and shouting as they played the day away. These monkeys were very playful and full of mischief, and they knew how to bring attention to themselves by throwing sticks and leaf trimmings over the edge of the falls and at each other. The Great Falls was spectacular as the bears viewed the delightful sight, with the sunlight dancing off the cascading water falling to the White Nile River below. The headwaters of the Great Nile. The huge Mount Kilimanjaro loomed above everything as it seemed to rise up. To heaven itself, at a staggering height of 15,092 feet tall. The top of the mountain appeared like a plateau, as though the giant had recently blown its top. It is the tallest mountain in Africa and is not completely inactive, as gases emit from the crater periodically and magma of molten lava lay hundreds of feet beneath the crater bed. This volcano actually is three large overlapping stratovolcanoes layered upon one another. Everywhere the polar bears went, Mount Kilimanjaro seemed to follow them, and they did not know what to make of this phenomenon. Glacier and Snowglow found themselves in awe of this ancient mountain and kept looking at it everywhere they went. Mount Kilimanjaro is also a microclimate for almost every tropical and rainforest and semi-arid and desert, all in one. Different elevations, different aspects of nature prevail on that mountain,
and it is also a park preserve, and the woods and forests are allocated for various uses. Sometimes elephants climb up partway on Mount Kilimanjaro on the foothills, and so do some rhinos. The Victoria Falls are so robust that they can be heard 40 miles away. They could not always see it because of clouds that surrounded the top of it. The mountain had the special ability that high mountains held, and that was the ability to create their own climates, pulling moisture out of the air as swirling clouds danced atop, around their tops. Sometimes, glacier and snow glow would come upon some especially touching scenes before them. The other day they had come upon a pair of giraffes standing beneath some boa trees as the sun was setting. And the day before that they had seen a giant lone male king of the jungle, elephant, under another beautiful tree, silhouetted by the sun.
Thank you.
Each polar bear had an ancient, timeless light within their eyes as they looked upon each of these sights. For they knew as beautiful as Africa was in the rainy season, they still traveled many places where the sun shone brightly, though not generally accompanied with the heat waves that dominate the continent much of the time in other seasons. Glacier and Snow Glow were elated to be in Africa, and Africa would now always be dear to their hearts. But it was nearing the time when they must resume their trip towards home. They dilly-dallied and stalled as long as they could before they turned their faces back towards the western Africa. Snow Glow led the way back to their iceberg, which they hoped would still be waiting offshore for them to swim to. Glacia was close behind him, and her nose frequently touched Snow Glow's shoulder or licked his ear as they walked. The trip back west was as eventful as it had been when they headed up the Congo River, because coming one way and then seeing it from another direction made it look all new and interesting all over again. They made good progress on their travels and preferred to travel by night versus day, and as they walked, their senses told them the story of what had transpired since they had last passed through this area. The animals, reptiles, birds, and insects left their pheromones behind everywhere they went. Snow Glow and Glacia took in all the information from these pheromones, chemicals, scents created.
Thank you.
by the animals, and they read other odors left behind these critters as well. The bears collected all the signs, smells, and signals of pheromones to create images in their brains, interpreted like a TV show for them to see all that had transposed, occurred during their absence. Glacia and Snowglow saw in their mind's eye the entire happenings of the areas they moved through, heading to their happy den on the iceberg out at sea. Everything was safe and sound all the way back to the coast. Snowglow and Glacia scanned the seas offshore, trying to find their iceberg. Finally, Glacia saw it just to the north out at sea, about a mile from shore. She said, "Snowglow, I see it over there to the north at 10 o'clock low." This meant that if the location were to be compared to a clock, it would be north and northwest. They were happy to see the sea and their mode of transportation. Snowglow motioned to Glacia with a happy swish of his giant head that it was time they raced north on the beach before swimming out to their iceberg. Snowglow had a slight head start up the beach with Glacia not far from his heels. They reached the beach nearest to their iceberg and launched themselves like white missiles into the oncoming waves. They pierced the waves with such skill and perfect harmony that no trace was left behind them. They climbed onto the iceberg, danced a happy jig and kissed noses, then watched Africa as it slowly faded off into a blurry haze. Africa was now behind them, and they were now the wiser and happier for the experience. They sailed the high seas with the high points of the iceberg as their sails. They were making good headway towards South America, moving through the South Atlantic Ocean. Their course was set at a latitude of 15 to 30 degrees south and a longitude of 30 degrees west. If the ocean current kept up at its present speed of approximately 45 miles per hour, they would reach the tip of South America in good time. The bears were on their way to South America. Unless the wind changed its course, the ocean its current, or some other mishap, the trip would go on as planned.
Thank you. Thank you.